Let's look at this point from three different angles. The first, generally, when do we get angry? We get normally angry when things don't go as per our expectations or as per basically the way we want, generally. So let us say there is a situation or there is somebody basically who is doing something which you don't like at all or which you hate, and somebody is consistently doing something which is making you angry. So at that particular point, you need to basically ask yourself, am I incapable of managing this person or this situation with my brain? See, if you could have managed that situation or managed that person with the help of your brain, with the help of your mind, or with the help of your intellect, you will not get angry. You get angry when things don't go as per your plan. So that's the first thing. Am I incapable of managing the situation or managing this person with my intellect? So what is going to happen is at this particular point, your ego basically will come into the picture, because your ego will not allow you to admit that you are incapable, but at the same time the situation is going out of your control. And in this confusion, basically you will see that to a very good extent you will be able to control your anger in that certain situations. Number two, you need to basically see, when you get angry, what exactly happens to you. You deplete the energy. It does not matter whose fault is there. So for example, somebody is basically misbehaving with you, or somebody basically is doing something which is totally wrong according to your thought process or according to your understanding. But it doesn't matter whose fault is there. If you generate the anger inside you, you are the one who's going to suffer. You are the one who's going to deplete your energy. If you eat the food at that time, it will almost become like a poison. You are the one who is going to disturb your digestion system. You are the one who's going to increase your blood pressure. So you need to basically be aware of it, that it does not matter when you are getting angry whose fault is there. If you get angry, you are the one who is going to suffer. So you need to ask yourself, do you want to suffer? Point number three. Now, the first two points basically which I have explained to you, even though they makes perfect sense intellectually, but generally it happens that when the actually anger comes, we are not able to control our mind, and we basically get angry. And then often basically it happens that we think in the hindsight, maybe I should not have get angry at that time, but you've already basically lost the temper. So how to basically reach to a situation where we are never angry? Okay, now a stage basically where you will never be angry is the highest stage of a human development. So for example, Buddha, the stage basically where you get rid of all the impurities out of your mind, then only this stage will come basically where you will never be angry. But nature basically is very kind to us. So it's not that only when you reach to the highest possible stage of human development, where when you become Buddha, then only you will get rid of whole anger. As you progress on the path of taking the impurities out of your mind, as much you progress, that much anger basically you can take it out, or that much control you will develop over your mind. And another amazing thing will happen is that as much anger is going away, that much compassion you will develop for the other person. And that will happen all automatically. So if you basically want to proceed on the path or reach to the point where you never get angry, you need to basically take impurities out of your mind. It's all basically because of impurities we get in anxiety, we get depression, we get anger, we get fear. And the easiest and the only best method is to basically practice meditation every day, morning, evening. I know you might have seen many of my videos, and everywhere in the end I will try to suggest you, because this is one thing which can actually help you in almost every area of your life. I will give the link in the description for 10 or 20 minutes morning, evening guided meditation. It's a non-religious meditation based on the breath. So you can try that. So the three angles basically I try to cover. Number one, whenever basically you feel like getting angry, and if you are a little bit aware, ask yourself, am I incapable of managing this situation with my intellect, with my mind? Number two, if I got angry, I am the one basically who's going to suffer. It does not matter whose fault is that. And number third, practice meditation morning and evening every single day. It will help to get rid of impurities out of your mind. And then you will start noticing it yourself that you are getting less and less angry. Earlier there was some situation where you could easily get angry. Now you are not able to. Or earlier you get angry on situation and you stay angry for 10 hours. Now basically you may be angry but only for 10 minutes. So that way, as much impurities you start taking out of your mind, that much basically you will be less and less angry. If you have any other query, feel free to put it in the comment sections. I will be happy to reply it. Thank you very much for watching it. And if you feel that the video is informative, feel free to share it with your friends or family members, so at least they can also get some benefit. Thank you very much for watching it.